Hello. Okay, today we're going to be talking a little bit about sound and the different programs and options that are available, like MPC stems out of the AK Professional Beats library. MPC stems is pretty cool. It's kind of what got me into being an audiophile, which is audiophile is just you're crazy about sound quality. So it's pretty cool. You get the records, you get the records, and yeah. So you need a device to use MPC stems. So if you want to get that, you go to akpro.com. And you see the products. I have the MPC Live 2, which is this one here. Now this one just came out. It's pretty cool. It's about 1,000 so bucks. I also have the 25 key keyboard controller. Now I was gonna get this too, but I already have the pads on here, so I really didn't need that. So let me just play a WAV file for you here so you can see the quality of it.
Cut my life into pieces. This is my last resort.
So let's just let
Suffocation,
you
no
play.
breathing. Don't give a f if I cut my arm.
If I turn it up all the way, it's you can already tell the sound quality is much better than an MP3, which is the standard. So if we go to this file, this file is 33 megabytes, and it's a wave.wav file, audio file. So there's a few different options you can do to go about getting wave files. So I'm gonna go to Cobuz. And you can download this, and if you you can download the desktop version if you want. I think it's this is 1083 a month, but you don't get the highest quality. If you want the highest quality, you get the 1499. And that'll give you a FLAC file, but I don't like that because it's not the highest quality. But I do have this. In fact, I bought this one, then I tested out this one, and it is pretty cool. It does sound really good on the actual app. So if we play, I like the Nirvana Unplugged album. The sound quality is awesome. It's just awesome on this. But if you're looking for better quality, even better quality than that, I wouldn't recommend Tidal as far as the sound quality on the app. But if you go a roundabout way and you get the Tidal subscription, and they're recently the most recently doing the combining the Hi-Fi and the Hi-Fi Plus together with just one subscription, I assume it's gonna be like $15 a month. Because they're kind of like combining them both and just like saying you can have this for the price of this, but we're gonna put everything in one thing. That's probably the best plan to do, $15 a month. And then if you go to, and then I also wanted to mention Winamp. I have the original Winamp here. It's not really like used much anymore, but it is.
Cut my life into pieces.
It is pretty cool for the old 90s nostalgia. And then what I wanted to show you was, I don't think I searched it up here. Let me see. Okay, so this is the HitPaw video downloader. And it's AI powered. It converts video and audio files in 1,000 more formats, 120 times faster speed with just one click. Convert Apple Music, iTunes Music, Spotify Music, Deezer Music, and Tidal Music to MP3, MP4, M4A, AAC, and more. Batch convert GIFs. 100% removes all noises and vocals from any song if you want. It's a free download. So you just click it to download it. And then if you wanna pay for it, it's like $72 for lifetime. And then I'll show you what that does. So that's this here, this HitPaw video converter. So you can convert any video file, any download, URL, YouTube video, music file. And what I like about it so far, I've only gone over the music features, but the Tidal music converter, all you gotta do is import the link here. So if you go on your Tidal subscription, where is that? And we go to Papa Roach. Say you want, where'd the albums go? Let's go to the albums. Say you want Infest with the explicit. You just click on it. And you go to copy URL, and then you paste the URL in here. Now, if you're wondering what the URL is, I'm sure you know what a URL is, but it's just HTTPS dot colon slash double slash list and title. Album and then the album number. So if you just you can just right click on here and paste that in, and then you can choose what file format you want to convert it to. So you don't want MP3. FLAC, you could do FLAC. FLAC would be save on your hard drive space. But what I like is WAV. And then you choose an output folder. Browse the folder. Choose that folder. Don't click here, that'll just open the folder. And then you gotta hit analyze. And that'll get you all the songs in the album. WAV file. Then convert all. And then it'll do these 13 songs.
This is my last resort. Suffocation, no breathing, don't give a f if I die,
So
I'll bleed.
it's already doing a couple of them. Pretty quick too.
This is my last resort.
I did two of them. So if we take a look at this. Pauses. Take a look at the size of this file. It's 41 megabytes. Their average is about 50 megabytes, depending on how long the song is. But if you have the file room on your computer, that's great. But what I like about this is it allows me to take this file, and it's high quality, high def, and I could take it back into MPC stems. Where'd that go? So we got this HitPAW video converter. And I wonder if it converts MP4 files from AIVs or something, because that'd be useful too in the video game industry. This is all the stuff it does. MP4, YouTube, Facebook video, Vimeo, Instagram, TikTok. And so if you're looking for listening quality on just the app, I would recommend Qobuz. Because that's a really good sounding just on the app. If you don't want the file, if you don't want the hard drive space, you can play this is a better quality than Tidal. But when you use the video converter, the HitPAW video converter, and grab it from Tidal, it gives you a better quality than actually showing you on Tidal. Okay, so they're all done downloading now. So let's open these in. Yeah, I like Between Angels and Insects. Open it in Windows Media Player. Play it. And, so anyway, what I was saying was, you could download this too. I don't know if you can hear me over that, but I'm gonna pause it. But this is fxsound.com. Download this. It's an equalizer. So what this does is, let's see if we play that here. Say you don't want your neighbors to hear your bass. Say you don't want your neighbors to hear your bass as much at night. That's what I use this for. You can turn this on and adjust the clarity, the surround sound, dynamic boost, bass boost. I usually turn these down and these up. And if you just turn the volume up, and you could do it for movies, TV, music, voice, gaming, so all sorts of stuff. I think this is free. And you just gotta choose your output speakers. So that's pretty cool. But what I like the WAV file for is I can then bring that into my MPC Live 2 and break it down with MPC stems. And what that'll do is it'll take your vocals, your bass, your drums, and other four different parts of the song, automatically break it up so you could use those as samples in your music making. And it's pretty cool. Or if you just want to listen to high quality music and be an audiophile, this is an option for you. So this is pretty cool too. This VZX player on Steam. It's a visualizer. So I have that open here. If we go to it.
We search for some.
Let's see, where's that open? I believe it's here. So if we play this. And then. It visualizes the music. So it's kind of like a that's a cool thing. You could do it also with music, and then this is the same thing, the VZX video player, but this is the desktop version, and this is the Steam version. Let's see, was there anything else? I guess Winamp is now. Like a streaming music thing. But they allow plans. Huh. Well, I know you could download Winamp for free, just the player, without getting the streaming music, but so yeah, have a look at Cobuz and Tidal. And was it Hitpaw video converter, and see which one works best for your needs. And the sound quality is great. I don't know if you can hear it on your system or on the video, but it's like listening to a live audio performance in a studio. I would never go back to MP3 again. I swear. So that's cool. So check it out. If you're really into music, you can get one of these or one of these keyboards and start making beats. I don't know, but the vinyls are nice because they have that like crisp fire warm sound, but these files have no scratches in them, if you know what I mean. Like they don't have any other disturbances or skips or anything like that. It's a pure file from the band. So, all right. I guess that about does it. I'll keep it on like under 20 minutes. I kind of just wanted to play this video here, though.
Hi there. This is Andy Mack from Akai Pro, and I'm excited to announce that we've now added stem to the iconic MPC workflow, opening up new boundaries, bringing us into a new era of sampling. Take any vinyl record, any sample, and extract the stems, giving you drums, bass, music, and vocals with incredible sound quality inside the iconic MPC workflow. Now let's take a closer look how stem separation works inside MPC. Now the first thing we need to start with is a sample. Now I've got like a real classic sounding sample here.
I remember this video. Yeah, I remember watching this video before.
Now the
Turn the lights.
This sample, it has all of the elements that we need, which is drums, bass, vocals.
So this is really cool the way he does this. It's basically just like a song file. It's a file, and
this is where
takes the drums, takes everything out, and separates
it. So
it.
let's use our start and end points to find the part of the sample that we actually want to stem out. So I'm going to use this section. Now we go to process and we navigate all the way to create stems. Here
create
you'll
stems.
See four stem
Okay.
options that you can turn on and off. So if you don't want to stem out the drums, you can just simply turn that part off and then it won't be included. So we'll turn that on because we want all four parts. We can also
Yeah.
set up our assignment to our pad, which will send the stems to that location.
and we keep trim on, which is using our starting endpoints.
Okay.
So press do it. And then what it's doing now is processing.
I'm dying to try this out. I just had to get all the we'll navigate previous stuff
to our main menu, and now let's play our stems. Now in Program Edit is where we can control our four stem layers. Take out the bass, drums, vocal, bring it back, take out the music. Bass and drums. Let's bring back the music. Now, as you can hear, the sound quality is absolutely stunning. Now, if we also navigate back to sample edit, we can actually see our four individual layers in waveforms. So here, we've got our original sample, and now we've got the bass separation, drums, music, and vocals. So here, you could do all your traditional MPC chopping in real time or using regions, and then save those as a program and then start making beats with each of the individual stems. So let's make a beat out of the stem that we created. What I want to do is more kind of vinyl driven. Now these are some of Marco Polo's drum sounds from Pad Thai and Boombap Essentials. Now we just finish off adding a few extra hats and snares. Now we've got our beat where we want it. Let's go to another track. Set of baseline. Now we'll use 16 levels. Now that's really in the pocket. So there's our track done. Now let's go to our track view. Go to our inserts and let's add Flavor Pro over our whole sample. I'm going to really give it some more kind of lo-fi textures. As you can hear, using MPC stems really does open up the boundaries of what you can do with sampling with the iconic MPC workflow. Now you can also edit all four layers.
So yeah, that's about it. I'm gonna keep it about 25 minutes. I said 20, but I'll keep it to 25 minutes here. About so just the recap. MPC stems cool. MPC cool. I probably won't get Winamp, but. This visualizer is pretty cool. It's free. It's completely free unless you want to bundle it. But so this effect sound helps with keeping the neighbors happy at night, because these files, these wave files and these sounds are really high quality, and they do tend, if you have a good system, the bass is really there. So title, great. I think I'm gonna wait till they change the Hi-Fi and Hi-Fi Plus into combined one thing, and then resubscribe depending on how much it is. Cobas, if you just want to stream the high quality music, FLAC music. It seems like it's flat quality, 24-bit, 192 kHz, but when you play it, it's like wave quality. So, but you can't, when if you buy music on here, it's only flat quality. It's not the best quality. So, If you're just logging the stream, this is probably the best, and I think you can get the same quality in each plan. So for $10 a month, that's what Spotify costs you. You might as well listen to high quality streaming music. You know, if you don't want to deal with the high gigabytes on your computer and stuff like that. So, and then HitPaw video converter, awesome video converter and audio converter. And I just wanted to say it does actually, if we go to it, it has these options for music, Spotify, Apple, Deezer. Tidal is the one I'm using, you know, and that's the best one because it's the best quality. Amazon Music is nice quality, but it's not as good as Tidal and iTunes. So, all right. That's about it. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you do enjoy music after this better, because it's a new experience to listen to high quality music, and I think a lot of people are still stuck on the Spotify, you know, subscription, and it's not listening to the music how the artist intended you to listen to it, either on a headset or on a system, And I listened to Hendrix, Jimi Hendrix, and I felt like I was high listening to him. It's just crazy. It's ridiculous. If you turn it all the way up, you're going into a different universe. So yeah, enjoy that. Enjoy this, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.